Good day to everyone. My name is Vilvamalar Marimuthu from 18-19. Welcome to my video of public speaking. Today I would like to talk about the topic that was assigned to me, which is, should screen time also be limited for adults? Before I answer the question, let me briefly explain about screen time. Okay, what is screen time? Screen time is the time spent by an individual in front of electronic devices such as smartphones, computers, PlayStations, and so on. Screens have both positive and negative impact on adults. There's no denying that screens are a major piece in people's life. The reasons we should limit the screen time for an adult is, first, for more fulfilling relationships. Making the real world connections may give a sense of fulfillment to a person. A study done on 35 adults who were forced to give up their devices found that without smartphones can form more meaningful conversation and deeper friendships. When you are not staring at the screen, you are forced to be more aware of whoever is around you. The second point is to less stress. Stress and depression have been linked to use of heavy technology. In a study of University of Gothenburg in Sweden, researchers discovered a clear link between overuse of technology and social media and mental health risk. Scientists link heavy social media with depressive symptoms. Thirdly, to get better sleep. Nowadays, people spending more time looking at their smartphones before going to bed and the first thing they do when they get up in the morning. Researchers at Harvard Medical School looked into the connection between screens and insomnia. Unsurprisingly, they found that heavy screen usage is a major cause of restless sleep. And the fourth point will be to find own peace. By unplugging from the digital world, we can become more aware of the physical world, which did wonders for our mental health. Praying more and spending more time in silence will make a person feel more at peace and mindful of the world around them. The last point is to improve focus. Adults or teenagers will usually struggle to do many things or works at a time. Plenty of research reveals that multitasking is not efficient. In one UK study, those who multitasking while working on cognitive test drop in IQ level, which is equivalent to missing a full night's sleep. How we should reduce screen time for an adult? First, constantly turn away from the screen into the distance. Second, keep the neck upstanding when using a telephone or tablet. Third, must not watch movies or TV in bed. Fourth, cut down on computer socializing. Other than that, set a timer. We should try set a limit of how much time per day should you spend in front of a screen. And then ban phone charging from the bedroom. Take up another hobby for boredom. Lastly, daily exercises. Lots of simple stretches and workouts can be done from the comfort of our couch and living room floor. Screen time has both positive and negative impact to an adult. The advantages of screen time are they can be fun and also be helpful when it comes to learn new things. At the same time, advance in technology may improve a person's skills. And screen times also allow students to easier access for academic purpose. The disadvantages of screen time are it may lead to depression and can make a person less healthy or obesity. And lastly, it may lead to sleep problems. As a conclusion, screen time should be limited for an adult. Adults should emphasize the importance of their health more than fun. It is vital to find the correct balance with regards to how much time an adult spends using a screen. The additional time they spend on a screen, the less time they are being dynamic or mixing with other people. Remember, screen time is a reward, not a right. That's all from me. Thank you.